Hashim Thaci has also been seen hobnobbing with top Obama administration officials here in Washington. So what gives when it comes to D.C. choosing bad partners, and is history repeating itself? Joining me to delve into this further is Michel Chossudovsky, director of the Center for Research on Globalization. Michel, why is this news now? There have been allegations that this guy has been involved in these mafia-like activities for a while now. Why is this coming out now?
Well, this has been known for more than 10 years. The Kosovo Liberation Army, headed by Hashim Thaci, waged an insurgency on behalf of NATO. It protected the drug trade going through Kosovo and Albania. It was recognized by the U.S. State Department as a terrorist organization. It was actually even collaborating with bin Laden, Osama bin Laden. And so that, in fact, what we have is a complicity of the so-called international community going back to 1999 when NATO waged a war on Yugoslavia and then installed a provisional government headed by the KLA, by Hashim Thaci. In fact, at the beginning, what they did is they transformed the KLA into the Kosovo Protection Corps. They gave them UN passports. Everybody knew that these were criminals. The Interpol had advised the United Nations, and then what happened is that that the United States and its NATO partners appointed, I believe it was John Foley at the time, special envoy,
right,
who had the mandate to foster the transition of the KLA, which was a terrorist organization, to become a bona fide, respectable domestic political party.
And you know, you just mentioned there that everybody knew kind of that this guy was involved in sort of corrupt activity. If they knew, how could they be so friendly with him? We see these pictures of Hashim Thaci with former American leaders like George Bush, with current leaders like Hillary Clinton. What are they getting out of such a close friendship with him?
In fact, it was Madeleine Albright, which was the he was the protege of Madeleine Albright, going back to the Rambouillet talks in Paris, which preceded the invasion of Yugoslavia. Everybody has known this, but the idea was, the project was to install a mafia state. You install a mafia state, you control these people, and you use Kosovo as Kosovo has become a space with a gigantic U.S. military base on the one hand. It's the transit route for the multi-billion dollar drug trade. Those narcotics come from Afghanistan, we have to understand. It's the heroin entry point into Western Europe. And the international, well, let's say there are two international communities. There's one international community which has warned the other international community that these people are criminals. And they were supported by the so-called international community.
Right.
It's an absolute scandal.
I want you to talk a little bit more specifically about the American leaders. You know, we were just looking at those pictures of him with Hillary Clinton, with George Bush. And Hillary Clinton goes around accusing other leaders of committing horrible war crimes around the world, yet she seems to be friendly with someone like this. It seems a little hypocritical, don't you think?
Well, I mean, it's not really hypocritical because American leaders have also blood on their hands, and they're using criminals for geopolitical purposes. Criminals are very easy people to manipulate, okay, because they obey orders. If you and in Kosovo, there was an alternative movement. It was the Democratic League of Ibrahim Rugova. What happened is that the KLA was involved in targeted assassinations of a true process of democratization, if we can speak of these terms, which was led by another party. Ibrahim Rugova died. They say it was a heart attack, but I suspect he was not quite it was not quite him that should have been in the position of prime minister, so that they wanted Hashim Thaci there. And the KLA has become has been transformed into a civilian political party as a result. It's a shocking state of affairs, and now this this mafia state wants to become a member of the European Union.
Yeah, and you know, this isn't the only questionable friendship the United States has had with leaders who have been accused of corruption. Look at Manuel Noriega or even Hamid Karzai, for that matter. Is this story about Hashim Thaci all that surprising to you, really quickly?
No, it's not. Well, it's not surprising to me because I've been investigating these issues for over 10 years. When we first started looking at the Kosovo freedom fighters financed by organized crime back in 98, 99, even before the invasion. But but you're absolutely right. The United States and its allies install leaders. They're not necessarily criminals, but they're people whom they can control.
Right.
And then, of course, they close a blind eye.
Yeah.
Now, it's interesting that in Haiti, they did exactly the same.
I know, and it seems like the history keeps repeating itself. Michel Chossudovsky, Director for the Center for Research on Globalization, thank you so much.